We all know that we need better passwords, but it feels like too much trouble. Thankfully, it doesn't have to be, as I'm going to share with you in this guide to creating better and more secure passwords. Hi, I'm Josh, and we're going to start this with a little quiz. I want you to think of any one of your passwords, be it your bank, your email, anything that you can think of, and answer these four questions, yes or no. First, is that password longer than 12 digits long? Second, does that password contain uppercase, lowercase, numbers, and letters? Third, is that password unique, meaning that it hasn't been used on any other account that you have? And fourth, has that password been changed in the past 6 months? Now, if you answered no to even two of those questions, you failed. But that's okay, you are in good company. Trust me, so many of us are in the same boat. All that means is that we need to take a few extra moments to secure ourselves online by creating better passwords. And what I want to do right now is walk you through a three-step process to do that very quickly and very efficiently. Step one, select a process to create new passwords. Now, this is something that we need to do before we start changing our passwords, is we need to select that process. And let's lay some ground rules. First of all, changing letters into symbols is not secure. So changing password into password is not going to cut it. Likewise, if you can actually say your password really easy, such as crazy monkey with a capital C, an at instead of an A, and a zero instead of an O, again, that's a little too easy. Whereas if I were to give you this password, it would take me about 20 to 30 seconds for me to explain the whole password to you with the capitals, the lowercase, the symbols, and the numbers. That is a secure password, and that's what we're aiming for with all of our accounts, those kind of secure passwords. Now, before you get a little bit overwhelmed by the idea of having to create all of these passwords, let me explain that it is a lot easier than you think. There's a couple methods, some that rely on technology, and some that you can do on your own. Let's start with the ones that you can do on your own. My favorite method for creating these secure passwords is to use a poem or a line in a song or a favorite line that you like, whatever it is, and create a password out of that. Let's take an example of the poem Jack and Jill. If I were to take the first line of that poem and turn it into a password, it might look like this. Jack and Jill went up the hill to fetch a pail of water. Now, as you can see, this password is more than 12 digits long. It contains capitals, lowercase, numbers, symbols, and it's unique, or at least it's unique for this. How would you take and make this password unique for all of your accounts, especially if you don't want to be writing all of these weird ones down and having to come up with new ones every single time? Well, the way that I've gone about it, in some of the accounts that I've had, is I've taken, let's say I'm going to create a password for Facebook. I'll take the first letter of Facebook, an F, put it at the beginning, and then I'll take the last letter of Facebook, K, and put it at the end. And I'll do that for every single one of the accounts that I'm creating. If it's going to be Gmail, then I'll have a G at the front and an L at the end. That creates a unique password for every single one of them. Now, this is a much better method than probably what you're currently doing, but it isn't the most secure method. The most secure method is to just create randomness as much as you can without any sort of semblance of, what you could explain very easily like I'm doing right here. And that's where technology comes into play. There's a lot of password managers. I use a password manager myself called Dashlane. There are a number of others you can try. I've put links in the description below. What these do is they have a password generator, and you can find these even online as well. They generate a password that is very long, very hard to say, and you can just copy and paste that password in. Now, how do you remember that password? That's what we're going to get to in step two. The key right now is to set up a process to create the passwords. Is it something you're going to do in your head, or is it something you're going to do using technology? I recommend you use technology at this point, but that is entirely up to you. Step two, we need to create a way to store these secure passwords. Now, the last thing you want to be doing is writing down all these passwords on a piece of paper and having to bring that piece of paper with you wherever you go, or pull it out every time that you need to sign into one of your accounts. So what's a way that you can do that? Well, I already shared with you one of the ways, which is to create one that you can remember and that is unique for every single one of the accounts. The other way is to use, like I said, a password manager. Now, if you look, as I'm using this password manager, I've created all of the different accounts that I have, and there is a unique password that is set up for every single one of these accounts. And while I'm on my computer, it syncs with my phone and my tablet. all of those passwords stay synced up and it's behind a single master password that I need to know. For my phone, it can be my fingerprint, but for the computer, I need to have a secure password that I use that allows me to get in and add these passwords whenever I'm signing into all my accounts. All right, step three. Now we need to systematically go through all of our accounts and change our passwords. And before you freak out about how much time that might take, let's first just say what's important is to get your most sensitive accounts changed. I would go through, get a piece of paper, and list out the most sensitive accounts. Those are the ones that if someone were to have your password and to be able to get into these accounts, they could do irreparable damage to your credit or to your identity. So I would spend one day just getting all of those sensitive accounts, their passwords changed using either the method we talked about or a password manager like Dashlane. Once you do that, then you can go through and maybe spend 5 to 10 minutes a day or just any time you log into this new account like Facebook or Twitter or Pinterest, these places where yes, a secure password is good, but it's not absolutely going to destroy you if somebody hacks into that account. That's when you need to go through and change all of those passwords as well. It might take you a little while. I just decided to sit down with 1 or 2 hours and just knock it all out so that I had secure passwords. And if I have a password manager like Dashlane or others, when I try to log in, it will automatically input those passwords so I don't have to go through and copy and paste. The only thing I need to know is my master key password for that account, which could be my fingerprint or it could be the actual password on my computer. So to recap, you need to select a process to create secure passwords, to store those passwords securely, and then to systematically change those passwords. And that includes changing your sensitive account passwords about every 6 months or less. I hope this was helpful. If so, give it a thumbs up. Questions go in the comments below. And if you want to see even more great videos about how to secure yourself online, you can find those here in these playlists. Have a great week and stay secure.